Come on. Pull. Oh, shit. I was gonna say, I'm surprised it was that easy. Turn it off. I probably should have turned it off. No, never mind. I need the axe now. The axe is out of the wall. I am gonna say, probably cannot axe the tall man. He knows how to use doors? That's not fair. Can't catch me now? Okay, we got out. Would expect him to start teleporting at me. He doesn't know I'm here. He might know I'm here. Television noises sure are spooky, though. I don't think I could go up there. I was gonna try to go up the other hole when he started searching the one that I saw. But it didn't look like there was a way to do it. Stool. Aw, fuck. I was like, let me go exploring, and then here he comes. Yeah, that teleport is what I was afraid of. I might not have enough time because I wasn't ready. Oh, why am I jumping like that? That was a waste of a jump. Pull. I don't think I'm going to make it. He's got me. I've become television. Well, I mean, I wasted some time there. I thought going towards the door would be neat. There would be bonus over there, but no, he's scaring me. The, like, slowdown effect also throws me off. I think that's why I ended up jumping in the, in place. Can't catch me now. I'm roof surfing. On subway cars, apparently. Listen, I'd love to save you, Six, but this guy's like magic. Granted, that didn't stop Six from fighting the magic geisha mom. Who I'm not sure if there's actually any proof that it is her mom, but this dude can teleport. Like, come on, man. How has he not caught us yet? He is imposing. Like, he doesn't look the most imposing or scary out of anyone. But, you know, you don't have to when you got cool television powers. What did I do? Oh, the thing made the door open. I'm dumb. I'm stuck. Damn it. I got stuck on the... I thought I was using the pulley to get through a window. So when it didn't happen, I got scared and then the door opened. I'm dumb. I don't think I've ever seen like a pulley like this open the other cabin of a train, though. So it's not my fault. It's your fault. Unhook it. He can't catch me now, even though he's been teleporting. I'm on a train, bitch. Where are you going? I feel like this is very dangerous. It's going very fast. I see now that I might... Oh, no, I'm good. Never mind. I was gonna say, like, was I supposed to jump out? Because I saw a way forward, but I don't think that's how momentum works. I thought it was like one of those things of like, oh, if you're in a falling elevator, jump before you hit the ground and it'll survive. Six, I'm coming. Give me your static juice. It'll save me. I'm not doing so hot. I really hurt myself today. Is that the light from the tower? Up we go. I thought for a second we had the static effect on us still. But I think that might have been the after image of the six static glitch thing. I'm still in a dream. Snake eater. Ba-ba-da-da-da. Still not very close. But we're trucking it. I thought we were gonna keep walking forward. Okay, well, I don't think we can really hide here. Final stand. Goodbye, plastic bag. Imagine that being like any other hat and it just sliding away like that. Oh shit! I have psychic powers too? It didn't really work too well. Oh, I was supposed to- okay. I probably needed to do the tuning mechanic. And I needed to do it like way sooner. He took a tumble. I thought the whole thing was a cutscene. Really close. Come on. Get him. It's just where his hand is, I think. It's not random. It's definitely where he is aiming. I'm not afraid anymore. I'm a stronger television than you can ever be, old man. Now, if he used both hands, I'd be kind of SOL. I love the buildings just shaking with this, though. Makes me feel like a goddamn badass. I'm a goddamn action hero. Is he done? He got tuckered out because I was too strong. So, I mean, I'm gonna feel the same way as, like, the geisha with Six. Well, is he my dad? Like, television son? I need to do something here. Just destroying the whole city. I just pulled me. That was neat. That whole thing was neat. Pulled me all the way to the tower. I don't got no hat anymore. Time to turn off the telly. I'm guessing this is like the final chapter because that seemed very extreme. And this is the hallway. I get a good look at my face. Not right now. I want to see if I have the weird scary eye still. Oh, it opened on its own. I can barely tell what my face looks like. Oh, I'm zooming in on it. It's a little scary. I'm not a fan of it. The mask made it look better. This room is neat. I probably should have mentioned that. Like a goddamn magic dimension. Let me through. Okay. Guess I'm going this way. Sexist theme is playing, but like weird. I think it was sexist theme. I think it was like specifically called that in the first game. But you know, it's also main theme. Like playing when I'm close to the light. Do I have to listen to the music? I feel like I'm looping. I am absolutely looping. I saw my shadow. That's me! I don't see anything that I could be doing. Like, I don't see any other interactables except for climbing this, which I don't think is doing anything for me. I'm gonna see if I can close the door by getting behind it. That's gonna be what I'll try to do. It's definitely not working. I'm like stuck. Ah. Hey. It's a follow the music thing, isn't it? I just have to follow the music. That was simple. But I don't know, I thought it wasn't working. I don't know why I was like overthinking things there. I thought whatever this is, like a bag, I thought it was like blinking eyes. A good ascension up. How can I open door? Can I wait? I think he started trying to pull it. There's something in here. You can see movement. Aha! I didn't want to go through that. Was it my movement that I saw? Like that? Interesting. That was neat. Solving the puzzles, climbing the tower. Doesn't look like there's much more left. This seems like a hefty room, though. I see what the problem is. I didn't solve the puzzle yet. It's a really simple puzzle, but... No, it's this one. Almost made a mistake. Okay. We're getting there. Will any of this make sense by the end? Probably not, but I'm digging it. Okay. I don't think I can go back. Hello? I'd like your raincoat. Friend? We're friends, right? I'm not afraid of you. We're buddies? Okay, maybe I should be. Can I leave? I like the reaction if you didn't actually, like, zoom out. There was a hammer behind you. You didn't seem overly aggressive, so... Your jank arm. Smash the music box. You seem kind of okay with it. Hopefully that was okay. Come on, buddy. Okay, I don't think you didn't like it. I'm sorry. I thought it would be helpful. What is this? Oh god. I got really confused when that teleported me. Is this what the television does to people? Like the doctor and the scary teacher, like were they transformed to look the way they are because of television and that's what happened to Six? She seemed pretty okay until we smashed the music box. Frankly, I don't know why we thought smashing the music box would be a good idea. I mean, I made the decision, but you know. I'm hoping there is a way for us to, like, help her or fix her. It doesn't require us to axe her. She calm down a little bit. But she doesn't want us to smash the music box. I'm assuming that's what we're dealing with. Bamboozled you! Hurry! Like, I'm hoping this is positive. Like, positive results are happening here. I see the axe to the right. Would be a little upset if this ended up being like a... we're killing her by ripping out her heart kind of thing. Assuming we're gonna try to do the same thing. I shouldn't go back through. I made a mistake. I didn't think her arm would be able to get through that. I thought for a second I didn't have my coat on, but it's just the way I was angled. Kind of confused me a little bit. Ooh, this is gonna be a little rougher because I need to also get to the axe. Damn it. More than likely, I can't just grab the axe and run to it. She knows I'm there, like, immediately, so I need to do the yell. A little aggressive. A little too aggressive. Let's see. The best thing I think would be if she was in this corner. I mean, she knows I'm there. And she still kind of followed me in that way. Oops. Right, the arm comes through. I forgot. Maybe I'm overthinking things, and, like, that will work. Yeah, that seems simple enough. Now I just have to do this. I died. I wasn't fast enough. But yeah, that'll work. I was trying to get too complicated with the axe. Oh, the arm's coming through. Damn it, I forget about the arm. I think that I need to call her and because I don't think she's gonna fully interact with the door unless I do. And that's me being stupid. It's kind of funny, like, I don't think, it very much seems like the call button was not necessary for, like, anything except for this moment. Damn it! She pulled back in just a little too soon. Maybe I need it to call while I was at that door to make it last longer. There we go. Maybe I tried to get a little too close to the music box. Can't be much more of these, right? The music box is still pretty active. There it is. Be friends with me. Remember who you are. Okay. I don't think she remembered who she was. She seemed very ready to swipe away at me. Okay, don't get close when the when she's not ready for it. Well, when she's ready for me to get close, you know what I mean. Get music on, son. Oh, she's getting better. She's still a little cranky, but she's getting better, I think. Are you okay? What's all this goo? Do I have to hit the music box again? Come on. Okay, I was gonna try to hold your hand because we're buddies, but apparently not what I needed to try to do right there. That's a lot of goo. And an eyeball. Oh, lots of eyeballs. They're watching the television. I get it. I think I'm going too slow right now. There's a good chance I'm gonna get slimed. Oh, I needed to, I think, grab the ledge. Or I needed to be closer because it looked like Six was ready to help me with that jump. Come on, get me out of here. No, I just needed to grab the ledge. I wasn't close enough. Climb better. Climb better. Help me. Oh, nope. Six, help me out. Oh, I didn't jump. Oh, that's embarrassing. That was like the big climactic moment, too. Some action hero I am. Not even wearing my action hero bag. And then she just lets me fall. Would she? Why? Wait, why? I was joking. Why you gotta be like that, Six? Now I wish I would have killed you when I was fighting your big monster form. Lesson learned, never trust Six. Like, at that point, why even bother acting like you were gonna help me? Hey. Thought we were friends. Hey. I'm trapped in the goo. Oh. Scary eyeballs looking at me. Chair. More goo. Headache. Our little boy is growing up. The chair is growing with him. He became the tall guy. So my television powers were too good. How much time passes to make him grow up and become lanky like this? Well, I guess that's the end then. I like that. That was a good sequel to the first game. Of course, raises a lot of questions, but I think I prefer that than trying to give weird answers. I thought the whole thing would just be like, oh, do you not trust Six at all? You probably should have, but no, never mind. I never trust Six. It was a mistake when I thought that I should be helping her. Should have been trying to axe her arms instead of a damn music box. I think it was a lot of cool visual stuff still. The team behind these games really just knows how to make unique and bizarre areas. I don't really fully understand what was going on with televisions, but that was definitely the important thing. Child became the television boy. But that in itself seemed like more of something the Six caused. I don't know why or what she is trying to do. I don't really know what we were trying to do either. With Six in the first game, you could at least think like, oh, she's trying to escape the mob, but then by the end realize that she is going to kill the geisha that is in control. I guess probably Bag Boy was still going after Television Man in some way. He seemed to want to go towards the door in the television, right? I don't fully know. And then, like, how did Six end up there and end up in the Hunter's Lodge in the first place? That's a lot of gap between getting out of a giant whale boat and finding your way to something like that. And I mentioned before, like, Six should still have some psychic powers, but it might just not be fully developed. Like, I mean, you would think that Bag Boy would have been able to do some wacky television stuff, since he could kind of, like, tune the channel to kill the other television guy. I'm assuming he was dead because he didn't show up again at the end. And then, like, what does the school or the hospital have to do with any of that? It's super neat. Those were great areas. But they were definitely, like, far away from everything else that was happening. You have, like, the kids with the empty heads. You got the doctor making fake people. They probably had real parts in there. But a lot of them were made out of fake parts. And then the citizens that actually existed in the town had just weird faces. I don't think there was much we could really say about that either. But they were addicted to television. I guess it was probably what the tower was broadcasting. That was like the broadcast tower. Hunter, I feel like, probably wasn't anything. He was just on the outskirts of town. He was just having fun with his taxidermy family, and we just ruined his life. Also, you know, we set off all his traps, so he wouldn't never be able to catch bunnies again. I was gonna say, so he won't be able to eat again, but we did shoot him, so I don't think he can eat again no matter what we do. I'm surprised, like, we killed everyone except for that teacher. I would imagine at some point there will be, like, real DLC. I mentioned it before, but there's, like, the gnomes in the attic, which I think is just, like, a quick puzzle that will get you a gnome hat. I didn't ever look into it, but I feel like that's not really as important as, like, a story-heavy, like, three-chapter thing, which I hope they do a chapter story. I don't know what I would want. Maybe probably a stretch, and I don't know if it will be of any importance, but it would be kind of neat to see maybe aspects of what Six was doing before she reached there, that area. I would almost feel like something where we would actually end up finally dealing with that teacher. I mean, they reused a janitor in the DLC before. But that wasn't like, we didn't kill him in the DLC, it was just he was still there because he was a pretty good bad guy. But yeah, that was great. Everything I could have wanted from a sequel. I'll probably go back to try to like collect and do everything that I missed. And then I think end up showing off some bonus stuff when I was playing the original Little Nightmares, because there was some fun, like, geisha rooms, like a weird little shrine and stuff. I don't really remember what all of it was. So if I end up finding a weird room, or if, like, there's a neat little secret, I'll probably try to show that off, because I do really like the game. And I'm looking forward to maybe finding more things out. I'm just happy again that they didn't, like, mess it up. They did a good job with the sequel. I would like a lot more of this, because this is a very unique experience, these games. And whatever, whoever specifically is doing, like, monster design or visual design, they are doing a bang-up job with this game. The music's great, too. Like, all of it's great. I don't want to, like, slag anyone else. Like, oh, man, that guy who worked on the lighting, he could have maybe put more effort in. No, it was all good. It was all really good. But, like, you know, the main selling point, I think, what really makes this unique is that art. I wonder if there's a post-credit thing. So those glitches that I was collecting seemed like just after images of children that were taken away from by the television man. Were they... So television man wasn't like... Oh God, there's a lot of thoughts in my head. Because whatever happened to Six that made her into a big monster mash... I assume that was because she was brought into the television. So did that make people into monster mashes? Like, were the adults that we saw, were they turned into that from the television, and that's why they were like addicted to the television? I thought that noise was like something, but it's just scary. I don't want to try to put way too much thought into this, because again, I think it's fine just being weird. Like, I don't need the full lore of it. I just like all the wackiness. But like, it makes me wonder if the television causes everyone to be the way they are. I think I mentioned it before, like, possibly that's why the teacher is weird. That's why the doctor is climbing on the ceiling. The tall man himself didn't really look too crazy. The geisha had a bit of a, like, melty face. I don't know if that would have been the craziness. But, like, if the television, that broadcast is what did it, where, God, and then, like, where would Six have gone out to? Because she was going through a television portal. And then, I would think that what happened is it wasn't so much that Bag Boy died, and when he died, he turned into the television man, but probably because the slime got him since she let go. Since Six let go, that probably mean, like, is why, like, you are in control now. You have to be television lad. Sit in your chair, goddammit, grow long and lanky, get a hat. That hat's gonna come out of nowhere, it's your hat now. And, like, I wonder, is Six just going on a killing spree? There is definitely a couple of interesting things of note that happened with Six. Seeing her, like, just kind of sit by the fire after we burnt the doctor, it was a little bit of a weird one. It's fine that she was messing with the hands of the mannequin, but it was like she was snapping them. I don't think I remember her doing, like, really anything else, but I also wasn't paying attention. I did notice she was coughing a bit when I didn't realize it was her. And I don't know if that was the hunger kind of thing. Like I said, I don't know. Like, that didn't really come up at all. The, like, the weird, I hunger for flesh and the superpowers. Unless if her being a big monster had to do with that, but I don't think that would have been the case. And then, I guess I wonder why she had, like, a kid's room in the tower. A lot of stuff to wonder. Very much. Oh, I can zoom. I should have tried that in the first place, because now I'm trying to think of things to say about the game. The environments were nice. I like how unique they were. I feel like the school seemed kind of like the longest, but I also was struggling a bit with, like, dealing with the kids. The hands were a lot easier to avoid. I'm sure they would have just choked me out if they grabbed me. but the children were difficult for me to handle. I mentioned it before, I thought that the woods would be a lot longer. I guess it's fine that it wasn't. Why was Bag Boy out in the woods? Bag Boy was by a television. So like I said, like, because he has the same powers, it almost makes me think he's like the kid of that person. But then like, what's the deal with that? You're like a magic. Oh, there was an end memory that I missed. I feel bad missing those. You got like a magic TV man that seems to be stuck in that room until you open it. So when did he get a kid? I don't think I'm going to really notice a lot that'll fill me in when I play through the game again, but that was good. Well, how much stuff did I miss? Lots of stuff. I got all the hats there, missed two glitching. Glitching remains is what they're called, okay. Missed two glitching remains at the school. Missed a hat at the hospital. I missed all the hats at the city part. And then there's nothing there. So five chapters. I'd say I did decent. But I have to go collect all that stuff. What does resume game bring me? Probably to the last checkpoint, right? Probably shouldn't have resumed. Yeah, just to the slime. I don't think there's really much else I can do here. So that was Little Nightmares 2. I've become Television Man, and it's kind of a bummer. So it turns out there is a secret ending once you collect all of the glitchy remains. I doubt it has anything to do with this aspect, but I don't really know when the secret ending starts. Obviously, I've collected everything now, so we'll get to see what happens. Save me! Maybe Six will like me now? Also, our main character's name is Mono, apparently. Fun fact, turns out there is a lot of information you can find on the Little Nightmares website that gives a little bit of insight on some things. For example, the patients in the hospital area actually went there voluntarily because they were like bored or something. So the doctor was just doing his weird doctor things on them because they were like, yeah, just do stuff. They still don't really, they don't like explain too much on the website, which I'm more than happy with. But, you know, the insight is interesting. Additionally, there was something that mentions that the lady, the geisha from the first game, did her whole Ma thing to escape the surface world because she didn't like how things were going. Which, maybe that is why she has, like, technically had an apartment at the, I think it was called Pale City when I was looking into some of this. So, you know, a lot of fun lore. And then still some unclear things. There's a lot of speculation that what happened here is like a time loop. Because once we see Mono turn into the Thin Man, which I believe is what he's called. Tall Lad is Thin Man. The door closes and we zoom out of the hallway, very similar to how the game starts, where you see the door close and zoom out before Mono wakes up next to the television. So potentially it can maybe mean a loop thing. It's either like he inherited being the Thin Man or he's time looping and like always suffering the same fate. Unclear. Again, not a lot to explain. I'm happy with that. The visuals are a lot of what really strikes me about this game, and it's enough information that makes speculation fun without being awful. So I'm good with it. I don't know what the last scene is. Hopefully it's not after credits. We do know we can zoom past those at least. But that's what kind of why I wanted to start where I did. I also collected all the hats, which was just for fun. You get the Thin Man's hat once you beat the game, which is neat. And then you just become Tall and Thin Man. But yeah, I really like this game a lot. None of the collectibles were in overly crazy looking rooms. Under a log, there was like a giant rat caught in a bear trap in the first chapter, which was kind of neat. They all were in like decent visual areas, but nothing that was I feel nothing that was overly worth discussing or looking at, like the geisha shrine in the first game that I happened upon and was like, yo, that's cool looking. Because for the most part, it's just like, oh, there's like a glitched remain is standing over a very shallow grave with a shovel. There's like a kid, a glitched kid fishing in the sewers in the Pale City section. And then some like caged animals somewhere on the roofs. I still think I did a pretty good job at collecting them all myself. I don't know why, I thought the leg of the chairs were like the thin man's arms. And that he just had very long arms. I was trying to look into it, I don't think the thin man ever did realistically show up in the first game. So maybe I just remembered seeing him for like a trailer or something. You could maybe speculate that he is related to the Hanging Man who is very tall and thin, but I don't know if that's enough to speculate that. So I think as soon as this door is closed, this is basically what we see at the beginning of the game, right? We see like the zoom out of this door, and then Mono wakes up next to the television. Which, you know, that makes sense for some kind of weird time loop. I'd imagine the reason 6 probably dropped us is because we had like that weird scary glitch power. If you notice during the hospital, at least, when she pulls us away from the television, she kind of looks at Mono like she is afraid or concerned. Maybe she's just not sure what to deal with him. And then here's the secret bit. That sure is a television. Is this like 6 jumping out of it when she escapes? Yeah, get out of there. I mean, I assumed she escaped when she left us for dead. Ooh, there's the glitchy shadow. Apparently you could see that shadow when 6 was eating things in the first game. It probably didn't have the glitch effect on it. What is that? What was it looking at? That kind of looked like it was a picture of the Maw. Is this a prequel? Because the Maw was like a big whale with a steam stack on it. So it kind of almost looked like a lighthouse. I very much wished that it was a clearer picture. And also that wasn't as fun of a secret as I was hoping. I was hoping for way more information from that. But again, less information is probably for the best. But okay, that is Little Nightmares 2 now. I don't think there's a way I can quickly get past this. I doubt there's anything at the end. I'm just kind of hoping that maybe the like end screen will look different. Because in the first game, didn't it look like the top of the Maw once you beat it? Like it changed from being the like staircase up to the top of the Maw, the like lighthouse looking steam stack. I'm curious then, because I thought very Little Nightmares, the mobile game, was a direct prequel to the first game where, like, it led to 6 going to the Maw. But, I mean, if she has a raincoat now, then very Little Nightmares would be a prequel to this as well. Unless if, I don't know. So many questions. Too many questions. I'm not going to speculate too much. I don't want to get all game theory-like on this. But hey, if you have some questions, check out the website for Little Nightmares. Every character basically has a little blurb that mentions something in a vague sense. Basically, the blurb mentioned that the guests in the first game, the big fat guys that were eating, fuel the Maw one way or another, which, you know, that's foreboding. So, you know, a lot of fun details. or lack of details. Iberica.
But yeah, I liked the game a lot.
It was a very good sequel to the first game. I'm hoping for real DLC. I heard the Gnome Attic was not very good or worth it. It was apparently very short, and it's mainly just for the hat. I think it was probably a pre-order bonus, so it's like, oh, you know, it's good if you pre-ordered the game, but yeah, I'm not going to do the Gnome Attic at all. But yeah, if there's like DLC that's like the same chunk of content as the Secrets of the Maw, was that what it was called in the first game? I don't recall its title. And then it was like all chapter titles. But if there's something like that, I definitely will want to play those. If it's chapter based, I'll probably wait till all the chapters are out. But yeah, Little Nightmares 2 was very good. And this zoom is not zooming enough.